Sri Gurubhyo Namaha children, today's class we are going to learn about reduction of metal oxide into metal. Last class we have learned the metal ore is going to be converted into metal oxide. Now in this class we are going to learn about the different types of reduction. The first method is smelting. In that smelting, we are going to mix concentrated ore plus flux plus reducing agent. This mixture you are going to apply into the blast furnace. The ore present in the metal present in the concentrated ore is going to be converted into crude metal. So here you know that already we know the concentrated ore, and we are going to remove all the impurities. Only the metal is in the combined state. And next, what is meant by flux? Flux is a chemical substance. That forms a fusible slag with gangue particles. So already we remove most of the gangue particle in the concentration of ore. Still some of the gangue particles are remains in the ore. That can be removed by adding flux. What is meant by flux? Flux is a chemical substance that form a fusible slag with gangue particle. This slag can be removed from the blast furnace and we can get the crude metal. In the smelting process, concentrated ore is going to be mixed with the flux along with reducing agent. This can be applied into the blast furnace. You are going to get the crude metal. What is meant by flux? Flux is a chemical substance that forms a fusible slag with gangue particle. Now you are going to see the reaction taking place in the smelting process. Now for example, iron ore, here we are going to use carbon monoxide as a reducing agent. Here the iron oxide can be reduced into iron, and carbon monoxide can be converted into carbon dioxide. Now here how many? 4. So if you put here 3 plus 1 4, 2. So carbon become 2. So 2 plus 2 2 plus 3 5. So in that now you put 3 here and 3 3 2s are 6 oxygen, here 3 plus 3 6 oxygen, and iron here 2 iron and you put 2. So this is balanced equation. So now here the iron oxide can be converted into crude iron metal by applying here the carbon monoxide is a reducing agent. And next, what about the gangue particle present? Here the gangue particle is silicates. Silicates are present as a gang particle. The silicates are acidic in nature. So now you want to apply a flux as basic in nature. So the calcium oxide is act as a flux, and this is going to be combined and to form a fusible slag called calcium silicate. This is slag and this one is gang particle. So the concentration of iron oxide is going to be reduced by using the reducing agent carbon monoxide to form crude metal along with carbon dioxide. The gang present in the ore particles can be removed as a slag by treating with a flux. Here the gang particle is acidic in nature, so that we are going to add a basic flux to form the slag particle. So now we are going to learn about the copper pyrite ore. The copper pyrite ore is going to be heated in a blast furnace. It's going to be heated in a blast furnace. Here the copper pyrite is going to be converted into copper sulfide plus iron sulfide plus sulfur dioxide. Now the ore particle, the concentrated ore particle is going to be supplied to the blast furnace to the high temperature in the presence of a flux. The ore is going to be converted into copper sulfide, iron sulfide and sulfur dioxide. Now you want to balance the equation. Here 2 copper, so if you put 2 here, next you want to balance iron, so here only 1. If you put 2 here, the copper and iron is going to be balanced. Now you come and see that sulfur, 2 into 2, 4 sulfur. So here 2 plus 2, 4 and oxygen, O2 and oxygen. So everything is going to be balanced. Now you want to concentrate copper sulfate, so other material, other metal ion also present that can be act as a flux. Here this, the iron sulfide again on heating, the iron sulfide can be converted into iron oxide FeO plus sulfur dioxide. So here sulfur 1, oxygen 3 and this side oxygen 3 and here only 2. So now you want to balance oxygen. If you put 3 here, 6 and if you put 2, 2 plus 2, 4, here 2. Now see, now 6 oxygen, and if you write here 6, 2 in 1 into 2, 2, 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6, and sulfur, 2 sulfur and iron, if you put 2 here, so now the equation is going to be balanced. Now this iron oxide is act as a flux in this process. So this iron oxide is going to be react with the silicate. Iron oxide is going to be react. This one is flux and this one is gang particle to form iron silicate as slag. So now in this ore, the iron is going to be removed. Next, now we want to concentrate on copper. Then C2S plus oxygen to form CuCO2 plus SO2. So now here the sulfide form of the metal is going to first converted into oxide form. So now you see that balance 3 of the 2, 3 in this side, only 2, so you put 3 here, become 6, and if you put 2, 4 and here 6, so 4 copper and 2 sulfur and 6 oxygen. Now some of the copper sulfide are remains unreactive during this reaction, so that unreactive copper sulfide can react with copper oxide to form metallic copper, and sulfur is eliminated as sulfur dioxide. Now you want to balance the equation. Here was 2, so oxygen SO2, now you 4, 2 into 2, 4 plus 2, 6 copper. And now you are going to get the metallic copper along with the evolution of sulfur dioxide gas. During this process, the gas can be evolved. So, the metal can be exist in the form of blister form. So, that it is called blister copper. It is called blister copper. This is about 68% of pure copper. 68% of pure copper is called blister, because in that metallic surface, the during this process, the sulfur dioxide is going to be evolved as a gas, so that the appearance of the metal is seems to be blister. So that it is called blister copper.